to Los Vikingos TV, and today we'll talk about the La Liga match between Barcelona and Real Madrid. So, I thought this was another Clasico where the better team lost, in my opinion. I thought Madrid were calm and composed most of the match. Maybe, you know, they lost sight of it for a little while, but it wasn't much. But, you know, I gotta give my hat off to Barcelona. What a game by them, and especially their back line. I saw, you know, from what I read, a lot of Real Madrid fans were upset with Bale. I didn't think Bale was that bad, to be honest. I thought Barcelona did a great job. They couldn't get anything started. They were trying to be inventive, but they weren't. They really lacked that final pass. And why couldn't they get that final pass? Because the Barcelona backline was there, specifically Gerard Piqué, who by the 65th minute already had 13 ball retrievals. And not only that, in my opinion, he was my man of the match. And, you know, truly, I mean, when you play Leo Messi, it's tough, man. Leo Messi is a god. He's the best player of all time. I mean, all you have to do is watch that ball he sent, I believe, like the 13th minute, to Dembele on the left. I mean, beautiful ball. It was a perfect rate, perfect weight, perfect spin. Landed right into Dembele's path. It was amazing. The guy's truly superhuman. And, you know, he had a lot more involvement in this game than he did on Wednesday. This game didn't really mean anything because, you know, Real Madrid already lost La Liga. Now it's even more out of sight being 12 points back. But, you know, when you play Barcelona, it's obviously a pride thing, you know. But Madrid could have easily gotten at least a point or three. The one time Barcelona scored, it was a beautiful chip by Rakitic. So, you know, you can't hate on it. It was a nice goal, and I wasn't mad about it. I thought, you know, Ramos was a little out of place, but he was definitely out of place. He was in midfield, and that's why he got beaten. That was the reason for the goal, but it wasn't anything terrible. It was a nice goal. It wasn't a cheap goal. I was surprised Solari didn't rest some players, especially because, you know, he pretty much played the exact same lineup he had on Wednesday, and I'm sure he's going to play the exact same lineup on Tuesday as he played on Wednesday. So it's just, you know, nobody plays except for the 11 who actually play. And then it's the same usually predictable players off the bench. Though it wasn't today. But usually the same predictable players off the bench coming in to help out. I thought Madrid did a good job of keeping Busquets pretty quiet throughout the game. Barcelona's midfield, though. Man, Arthur Melo, he really is a baller, man. This kid is so good. He is obviously the heir to Xavi and Iniesta, and he is going to do a terrific job fulfilling that. And he is going to be the cornerstone of this Barcelona midfield for probably the next 10 years at least. Definitely more. Probably more. You know, we might even get closer to 15 years, which is pretty bad as a Madrid fan to know that. Because, man, this kid's good. I know Madrid were looking at him for a little while at the Club World Cup last year because Gremio was there. And they just weren't in on the kid. And, you know, he just fits Barcelona style perfectly. He's going to be a great fit for them. You know, it's nice to have La Liga having not just one, but two great young kids who can play in midfield. And I'm not quite sure how old he is, but I know he's not that old. So, you know, Barcelona's going to have him for a while, and, you know, he's going to be great for them for a long time. And before I get into Real Madrid, my last remark about Barcelona is this team could potentially win the treble this year. You know, they're going to most likely, they're going to win the league. That's no doubt. Atletico really needed us to at least take a point from them today, which we didn't. So Atletico is pretty much out, unfortunately. They're probably going to win the Copa del Rey against Valencia, and, you know, that only leads Champions League. You know, they have reliable players at every position. They have good backup players, you know. They use Roberto and Semedo on right back. And with that, they also can move Roberto to midfield, and they have Roberto, Busquets, Rakitic, Vidal, and Arthur in midfield. And then they have Malcolm, Dembele, Coutinho, Suarez, and Messi in attack. And then they have three center backs that are good with Umtiti, Piqué, and Lenglet. And then they have arguably the best goal in the world right now. You know, so they can definitely win the treble. They just got to really get past their away struggles in Champions League. You know, you saw it with Lyon. We saw it with PSG a few years, 2 years back. It was 3 years back. Then we saw it last year with Roma, too. But, you know, that's all I really got to say on Barcelona. Congrats to them, in my opinion. They deserve to win the game. I thought Madrid were the better team, but, you know, that back line really did a good job of shutting it down. They didn't let us get the final pass. And, you know, that was really important. not in Madrid. We lost 1-0. Like I said, could have easily tied or won. I thought we outplayed them just like on Wednesday. Even though Wednesday was more dominant, today I still thought we should have won. And you know what? I give credit to Solari for his subs today. I thought they were quite good. Courtois was, in my opinion, was great. He made some great saves, even on that one offsides call where Suarez hit that volley. That was a beautiful save. And honestly, I wish they didn't call it offsides because that save should have counted. That was a beautiful save. I thought the back line was pretty good. Carvajal was present on the right flank. Ron was good to put out fires.